What's up, y'all? We on the GoPro right now. What up, y'all? Yeah, we
this ain't no
here.
GoPro. This ain't no GoPro, bruh.
What is up? Good morning. Even though it may not be morning when you see this. What's up, High Scribers? I got a new little friend here, guys. Kind of faking my energy, I think, this morning. I don't know if it's because I'm getting old. I think it should be a decree that says you can't get up out the bed with your eyes open until 10:30 a.m. My wife got me up early this morning. Her auntie's in town. And yeah, I'm tired, man. I didn't put my pants on backwards this morning, y'all. That's bad. And I'm talking about not only did I put them on backwards, I'm lint rolling the mess out of my pants, y'all. I'm like lint rolling them. And I look down, because I got the little joggers on. And I'm like, dang, you know, I think I need to tighten up my drawstring. It was missing. Bruh, I don't know what it is. I just think that it's after this long week I done had. And my wife got me up early going to get breakfast. So, hey, this vlog, I want it to be about racism in the church. Now, a few weeks back on Facebook, I read an article that Lecrae gave about his departure from the white evangelical church. Maybe he got into some rooms and found out some stuff that we don't know. There's a difference. There just is a difference. So I stated that on my Facebook page, and it just seemed like all hell broke loose. I lost friends. People unfriended me. They were very offended just by my belief. There is a difference when you're a black person going to a white evangelical church. There just is. Different isn't always bad, but I did run into some bad. So we'll talk a little bit more about that. Hopefully I can get my aunt on camera. I want you guys to meet her. I'll probably see if I can interview her a little bit, and then I'll share more about the issues that I have faced in the church, LaShore and I. And man, I'm gonna send you guys back home. I wanted to really just use this as a conversational platform. Many of you are around the world, and I want to know how it is in your corner of the world as it pertains to racism. Just trying to put that disclaimer out. I am in no way trying to be racially insensitive. I am not trying to offend anyone. So before we go any further in this video, I do want to put that out there. No disrespect intended at all. You got it? Yo, okay, cool. So we can go forward? All right. You want to say who you are?
Hi, my name is Irene Blue.
And I'm Tony Blue.
So I guess that's make you the blues, right?
The yes, blues. We are the blues.
But you don't have the blues, though, right?
We don't have the blues.
So real quick before you guys go back home, we're talking about racism in the church. You got any thoughts, any comments?
It's a very real dynamic. You often look at church leadership, and you know they say that in order to be really a church that is representative of the community around you, you have to have people in leadership that are of all persuasions that you want represented, so that you can have diversity in thought, diversity in worship, and all of the above. We're in a position where we have left a predominantly African-American church, and we're aligned with another smaller church that's African-American primarily, but we partner with a non-African-American church, and that our services are held there, and sometimes we'll come together in unity. And that's what it takes. Even though we don't necessarily worship together the entire Sunday, we do have meals and things like that on a regular basis together.
Thanksgiving
and some other times. You have that fear, because when a pastor has to come across the pulpit and say and stamp out some of the issues with race that's been going on inside the church, it puts a little fear of you from wanting to take that leap to go to a predominantly non-African American church with leadership. And unfortunately, during this time politically, a lot of the differences the old ways of thinking has come out, and it definitely makes you more guarded. And so I know I've been deeply in prayer myself as to how to approach it with our children, what we're going to do with them in terms of long-term worship. And sometimes you feel as if the home church is going to be the thing, and aligning with those people who care for you, who love you, that you have relationships with, because the larger population, you don't feel safe. When you know that individuals are in other environments, they may not speak the way that they speak with you.
Right, right.
You know,
right.
So it's scary. Yeah, it's a scary time right now.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, when in Rome, you do as Romans do.
Yeah.
And sometimes I'll joke, I'll say, get your cousins, because, you know that these are people. I mean, I'll see posts on Facebook and I'll see that they're connected to people that I am in ministry with, even.
Yeah.
And, some pastors, and it's like, hey, and I'll just comment, I'll say, wow, and I'll tag their family member just to say, hey, your cousin talking crazy on Facebook.
Yeah.
You don't
get
them, you know. And so it's scary. It's scary.
All right. Well, you heard it. What y'all think? Comment below. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. Love you. God bless you.
When it comes to just that chocolate family, sometimes that's scary. Yet in other instances, if it's blended, it seems like it's a little more safe. And I don't think that that's a knock. I'm certainly supportive of interracial marriages and relationships. I'd walk in and say hello, and they were waiting on me to say what up, where you're like some mythological being. And I just don't think God is cool with that, because what's gonna happen, you're gonna limit me. I feel like this is what I want to say. Racism is the enemy of creativity. My aunt spoke of fear. God does not want his children to be afraid. I feel like when we come to church, that should be the one place in the world, out of all others, that we can find some solace, that we can find some answers to political differences, to social economic disparity, to a lot of the problems that we're facing in the world today. The church should be answering these issues. I always wonder, where was the church during segregation? Jim Crow, for those of you who don't know, Jim Crow in other portions of the world was one of the most horrible times, somewhat like the apartheid. But what I respect most about the apartheid, you guys got over it and moved forward. We still like to keep that portion of our country swept underneath the rug, and anything left alive is left alive. I really pray that in my daughter's generation, that her generation would learn to just put that stuff to bed and acknowledge it. And it can't just be black people. Other people have to accept and move forward too. So I want to sign off on this one. Like this video, please. Comment and subscribe. Become a high scriber. Say hello.
Hi.
Lala, you want to say hi?
Hello.
Say hi.
Y'all, we on the GoPro right now. What up, y'all? Yeah, we
ain't no GoPro. This ain't no GoPro, bro. So I guess I'll tell you guys what camera I did get. I managed to get the Canon EOS M6. And as you can see, it follows me everywhere I go. Man, that T5 was, I'm telling you, man, that T5 was giving me, let me show you my other cousin. Cousin, you wanna say hi?
Hi.
Tell them what's your name.
My name is Evelyn.
Are you from where?
I'm from Toledo, Ohio.
You like building stuff?
Yes.
Are you a builder?
I don't know.
Yeah, she likes.
But my Christmas list mostly consists of sledgehammers and wood glue.
To build stuff and
do. She wants a wrecking ball.
Sledgehammers and wood glue.